Hey, it's Andrew with Eagle Eye Power Solutions. Today we're going over the LBCC series, specifically how to set up a discharge test. So once you've connected your two main load cables and powered on the unit, you'll notice that you'll get a live voltage readout from the battery bank. Once we've done this, we can set up the test, which to do that, all we have to do is go to set. And you'll see that it will start with the end voltage setting. And it will be shown in the top right here. The great thing about this unit is that it actually saves your historic test set. So if you've set this test up before and you're testing the same system, it will remember that data and we won't have to modify it. So if you did want to modify this number or you're doing it for the first time, to adjust this value, you press the left or right arrow key. Left to decrease, right to increase, and then press the enter once we've selected our value. Then if we press the down arrow key, you will notice the LED light changes and it shows that we're now changing the capacity. For us, we're going to leave the capacity at 9900 because we're testing for time. So we can press enter to save and press the down arrow key to move to the discharge current. Here we have it set to 35. We're going to increase this to 40. So pressing the right arrow key, we can increase to 40. Once we've selected our value, again hit enter, then press the down arrow key. Here our discharge time is set to 5 hours. We can go all the way up to 99. We're going to leave it at 5, so let's press enter. So at this point, we've set up the entire test to what we want it to be. But before we start, what we can do is press the down arrow key, and we can go through all of our set settings and make sure that everything is set where we want. So we have 43, 9900 on our capacity, 40 amps for our discharge current, 5 hours for our test. So everything looks good here. We're ready to now start the test. So we can go to press run. What happens now is that this discharged light will start blinking a green LED. What that is doing is waiting for us to press the enter to confirm that we want to start the test. Once we hit enter, the test will begin, the fan will power up, and it'll start discharging our current value.